and welcome back to Cynthia's Conversation. Today's topic is a viewer request from a gentleman who said he literally had a times table how many times the madam is saying no, and the whole 30 days is no, no, no. But first, let me introduce my panel. On my right hand, I have Amaka, and then on my left, I have Yvonne. Ladies, this is from a gentleman who said he sent me an intense sheet on how many times the wife say no to, you know what I mean, intimacy in a month, and the whole 30 days was no, 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 no.
Yeah, but she has a period now.
So, ladies, how to help a brother? He does love her, but he doesn't know what to do at the moment. So he's asking us how to help him. I don't know why you two are laughing. Can you two just be focused?
Okay, you start and help the brother first.
Uncle, there must be a few factors on why the woman doesn't feel like saying yes in the whole 30 days that you do the time sheet. I'll start with, depends on her age. She might be going through premenopause, which is some women, not all women, some women will literally gone off having to sleep with their partner or husband. Some women might just tired. Some women might just don't find you bros attractive in that way anymore. It might be a medical issue. So I can't tell you now why she doesn't feel like sleeping with you. You see what I mean? So Yvonne, maybe you can. I don't know why you two are laughing.
This is not funny. I'm laughing because of the fact that he had time to draw up a time.
That's why I'm laughing.
You know? But the thing is, like, I mean, she has literally covered everything. The first step to your problem is sitting down and having a conversation with your wife. That's the first step. Because you need to know. You need her own side of the story. She needs to tell you what's wrong. Like Cynthia said, she might not even know that she's actually saying no.
Yeah.
You know, if there is a problem, or she's even trying to figure it out herself. It might be that she doesn't even know that she's telling you that amount of no. Women, I don't know what she does. Like, I don't know if she goes to work, then comes back. And because sometimes some women go to work, come back, housework, they are too tired, and then go to bed. They literally are looking forward to just go there, shut their eyes.
30 days in a month?
Well,
maybe he's asking for it.
I don't know her situation. You know, it could be that your sex drive is just so high that
size 14 shoe.
She's literally.
I'm not gonna give you the rest. Can somebody beg this woman to give you the rest? What the fuck?
You know,
what does the man size shoe got to do with the woman?
It might be that she's, you know, it might be that your sex drives are not in sync. Like, she's dried up and you are really giving it all you've got, and you know, she can't keep up. You know, or like Cynthia said again, you're just boring. You know, probably we need to start looking for ways to spice up. But you can't speculate on such an issue. You need to find out from her exactly what. Then we can work towards, you know, how, if there's a problem, then you can get help for it. If there's no problem and it's just a communication issue, obviously by the communication, both of you can work towards how to spice up that part of it. So that's my own opinion.
I'm not being devil's.
Someone is very excited. Okay, let's go.
You can be a size 14 shoe.
What does that got to do with it?
They say?
No,
let her. Size 14 shoe. Secondly, she might have found somebody else. She doesn't love you anymore.
Okay, hang on a minute. She said, let's explore what she just said. If you were okay with size 14 shoes, why she was when you first married, Why would you have a problem
after
now?
9 years and you want to do it every day?
No, when no, but
you get tired and bored.
Well, you know what you were getting.
You get tired and bored.
You know what you were getting into.
She was tired.
You know, and then if she's tired, then free the man.
Hey, but does hey, but it's not
free the man. The thing, like I said, if it's a medical issue, then she will seek help for it. But I don't buy this idea of 365 days in a year. No. You get what I mean? Because I have seen where someone was married for 19 years, for 4 years, she completely gone out of it. And then this man stayed for trying to say, okay, maybe she go get better, she go get better. And he never did. And then when he finally went outside, the whole world went loose.
Yeah, but you didn't have a conversation with
My question is, maybe she herself don't even know that exactly. She has this medical problem. I can far back as, I would say myself, far back as 10, 11 years ago, boy, my sex drive was absolutely up. Now, if I see a naked man standing, but it's true.
Yes, now.
And you guys know, if I see a naked man now stand in front of me, boy, nothing in my body will think of. But I guess mine is what they call the premenopause. When you get to that age, I don't.
And also.
And secondly, I can't be bothered, to be honest.
No, secondly, is she taking any contraceptives? Because some contraceptions actually lowers her libido. So maybe you guys have decided that you don't want to have any babies. Yeah. It might be the coil, because that affects, even the pill affects it. Mm. Even a lot of contraceptions tend to affect women's libido. So those are the things you need to explore as well. Because, okay, yes, I'm laughing about it, but it does happen. Mm. Some women, it affects them. And the other thing, she might even be depressed and probably not realize, like she said. She doesn't realize. So I would be upset if I found out that my partner had made a chart of the times I said no. Talk to this woman. If you love her like you said you do, to ask her, talk to her. We can't give you the answer because we cannot tell you. We're speaking as women, but these are the reasons some women do go off.
And if
she
you
might and, have, if you find out that she's fallen out of love with you, then you people can
that's
now talk
the
about
easy bit.
That's the easy bit. If it's
the fact that she's falling out of love with
that's
you,
easy.
That can always be rekindled. You can always go back to how people started. But if it's a medical issue that she herself is not aware of, she will have to go here with college GP. You will have to go to the GP and then let them do some referral. Because like Amaka said, which is true, some contraceptive
a lot of them actually
put you off
zero.
That you will be the same state I am. That even if a man stands in front of you, and you will know. But there are some women, it goes the other way. They have this contraception, their sex drive becomes really high.
Yeah.
Because to them, some women will have this contraception and their period will stop automatically. So they're free. And then when you have some women who will have it, they will continue, you know, bleeding for years. At that time, while you are going through that process of get used to some, you do not want no man to touch you whatsoever. Whether you are married in love or you don't want anybody, do you know what it means to be on your period for 365 days? It's annoying.
And then just another thing, like you said, did she change jobs recently? Maybe she's stressed in work. Have you tried to take, like Ibella said, she doesn't know what work the woman does, even if she's a housewife, even if she's a homemaker. You know, sometimes we women, we want variety. Just, if you can, just take her, remove, if you have children, remove those children, just her. Have you tried lighting candles? You know, like she said, try and rekindle what made you guys fall in love with each other. If that doesn't work, then you can explore the medical, because, you know, try and take her to a massage parlor, you know, try and, it's not just wake up when you come back from work.
But hang on a minute. It seems to be that uncle, even you said. Who take pieces and
I'm a writing. But what is wrong with you?
Uncle, take a piece now.
And I don't know if you've even asked her and she
exactly.
didn't give you an answer.
Exactly.
If in the case that you have actually asked and she didn't answer you, go back and find out other ways to ask her.
Thank
because
you.
Sometimes the approach also That's a problem. You could go and approach her now, and your manner of approach will put, she wouldn't even want to open and say anything to you, even if you were not even the problem, you know. So sometimes it's all about being sensitive, and like she rightly said, if you ask her before, you know, then you know, get someone to babysit the children. Take her out for a meal, you know, go back to those days where you were dating, you know, just get her happy, because at that point, I mean, it could even be nothing and just pure depression.
Yeah.
It could just be pure depression. It could be anything. And with we women, we, you know, hormones, depression, the, you know, the stress of being at home. Like, in fact, it doesn't even matter whether you work and you're a homemaker. Being a homemaker is a very stressful work, but people don't really understand. They think because you're at home 24/7, you're not anything.
That's
even the worst, because you don't get to see people, you don't get to interact with the outside world, that is just children, you know, everything going round. You know, when things are happening to you like a record, ground, there's no outlet for something fresh and new. That's enough to take you into depression in itself, you know. So I think you really, like I said, have a conversation with her, and hopefully it will be something that both of you can work towards. Okay.
Sorry, was it during this COVID I started writing? So for the past 6 months, if I was living somewhere for the past, maybe she don't tire now, my dear uncle. Sorry, 6 months every day. You know the two of you are bored. She's tired. So maybe she's tired. It's not food though. It's not food.
This COVID is turning everyone
crazy. No, is it during this COVID that she started saying no? If it's during this COVID, leave her. It's okay.
It's the COVID.
Every day.
Can blame the
COVID. Because you are not going to work, she's not going to work. Eh? Anytime she goes and say honey, first week will be sweet. Second week, bros.
Oh,
especially if it's size 14 shoe.
Actually, if it's even the COVID, you can actually, there are now new virtual ways of romance. So you could go and do COVID related.
You know, I'm actually looking at you both. I'm speechless. For the first time,
I'm trying to.
Can somebody please help me ask Amaka to explain what size 14 stands for? What does size 14 mean?
Why are you calling me? I'm having my water. Your size shoe. How would you hear that they say the size of your shoe is saying?
Finish the sentence.
Size of your shoe is the size of something. Come on, tell another person speaking every day. You want to kill her?
How do you see the size? The shoe.
I'm asking him if it's 14.
But you see her.
So hold on. So as he chatted now, he will also put hand to paper and reply you.
But we will not talk now. We won't tell anybody.
Even if he was, even if he was size 14. If she has taken it for the past.
But wasn't it? If it's COVID time, 6 months is every day you want to now. If they are going to work,
your eye, time. Risha. Hey God, please help me. How do I end up with this?
Okay, I'll keep quiet.
Oh God, oh dear.
Personally, I think there are many factors that contribute to why she's saying no. Whether she's just saying no because she had enough of, is a different matter. But most cases depends on her age, and sometimes some women even start their premenopause very early, before they turn 40. So basically she might be going through that, but she doesn't even know herself. So because of that, and her sex drive will just completely go down, and it won't matter what you do. Maybe you go put pepperoncino to write the medicine.
Or she started some contraception. And that in, that's, if you read one of the side effects of a lot of contraceptions, in fact most of them,
I can bear witness to that.
That's why it's called contraception, because you won't feel like having sex, so you need to get
belly. Exactly. So they know why they call it, and I tell you,
seriously, that's very true.
And that one of the contraception that I had, that's the biggest problem. It literally put you off.
And yeah, so just find out. Maybe she started contraception.
So maybe she had that. And or she's going through premenopause, which means her sex drive. Because what happens is when you are going through menopause, your body becomes so dry. You don't even, because sometimes, usually women, we have certain period in the month when you are ovulating that your body crave to have somebody.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, when you are going through this process, I think that is just gone. So you don't have that period that you even feel like every day becomes like, don't touch me, don't touch me, don't touch me, don't touch me. It's not that she fall out of love. It might be she
very irritable as well.
I think it's just, and especially when it becomes like you are trying to complete your chat every day, you ask, and she every day you ask, it just give her more irritation. You see what I mean? Just give her literally more irritation. So it's something that the first step is, I would say, don't show her the chat. Because if you show a bottle of fly,
tear up that chat.
In the no, it's not nice.
If I'm the one that I might find out about that chat, trust me, we'll be having words. Mm-hmm. I'll even say more no.
Mm-hmm. For another
2 weeks, no.
What 2 weeks?
For the chat.
Complete your chat for 6 months.
Yes now.
Because each time my chat. My yes, chat now. The
because it's
after it's 12 times table, 12 times,
yeah,
12 months.
Because I think that would be, because for me, I'll look at it that time you were chatting up, you'd have used that time to have done to, at least tried to woo me or something of that nature. So if you give me a chat or
wait,
I find out that you have a chat,
sorry, we'll wait, so when she says no, you go to the bathroom, chat to this is no. I'll ask you tomorrow.
Uncle,
she said no. Another chat.
Especially this one with my eyes. Don't take whatever she's saying seriously.
Okay, but seriously, it might be her contraception. Did you have been for even she might not be going menopause, she might have started some contraception for us, because you would know if she's on any contraception. So you never know, because that's probably a big factor, because a lot of times you don't want to have more children.
Yeah.
Especially if you are going to be at home for this long and you know sex is going to be regular. Okay, go on contraception, because we can't do safe period. Do you understand? Contraception is, you know, the most contraception is one of the side effects is it reduces your libido. So that's probably what it is, because if it hasn't happened before, it probably is, and she doesn't realize it. And then, like Yvonne said, ask her, talk to her and ask her, you know. Anyway,
but Yvonne, mm-hmm. Well done. Right on. But you know, like I said, it can be different reasons and different factors why she probably gone off it. But I said the first stop is to have a conversation. Sit her down and say, babe, honey, sweetheart, what is the problem? Please do not mention the chat. Because that will anticipate the matter and it will make it even hard to resolve. And then she might tell you, you know what, I don't feel like. And then you ask her, what do you need to do to put her in the mood? You know, me, my own is very simple, easy. Light me a nice candle in a bubble bath.
He's not asking about you.
I'm only saying that. Everybody said, you know, I just in a nice bubble bath, light me a candle there with a glass. Champagne gives me headache. And just give
sat down comfort.
Or a nice Italian wine, and then bros, the rest is history. But lately, I don't even sure say that like candlelight go do it.
and also, just to add something quickly, when you have that conversation, have the conversation, and also still give her space. Give her space as well. You know, even when she tells you, still respect her, give her space. She will come round.
Yeah.
If once you have that, and you support, because I think she needs support.
Especially since she knows you're feeling the way, if she finds out you're feeling that way, and you're feeling like neglected, she will come back.
Yeah.
And then, in fact, now you go beg her, okay, it's okay, I know what you get. I go do a chat of when you are saying no.
But anyway, I hope we've touched a little bit of what could be. Because we really don't know what the problem is. We just talk about what could be or why the reason why we think she doesn't. But if we haven't, please don't hesitate to contact us again and tell us the aspect that we haven't covered, and we're happy to do it. Until next time, guys, bye.